I'm Dr. Vinita Ketkar. I am a practicing family physician in Nishrantwadi since 1981. We started our yogic health science activity at Gnosis Medical Yoga Foundation in 2006. Since then, we are conducting two courses at Gnosis Medical Yoga Foundation. First is the basic course for beginners, which is called Medical Yoga Teacher course, and second is advanced course for yoga professionals and practicing family physicians, that is doctors. In first medical yoga teacher course, we teach them theoretical as well as practical aspects of science of yoga with a base of modern medicine. In that, we teach them human anatomy, human physiology, and medico-yogic applications. In addition, students are supposed to learn few sutras of Mahamuni Patanjali as well as some shlokas from Bhagavad Gita. They are supposed to learn by heart and try to apply it in personal life as well as help the patient with the theme explained in sutras as well as Bhagavad Gita shlokas. In human anatomy, in addition to the bony skeleton, joints involved, we elaborately teach them the major muscles of our body. The muscles like trapezius, latissimus, dorsi to name, many muscles are taught to them for their position, their actions, and what happens to these muscles in day-to-day life. So later on, they can apply this knowledge for knee pain, low back ache, and neck pain, as well as shoulder pain. In addition, they are also taught about the brief introduction of nervous system, wherein they learn the basic structural aspects, which are the parts of nervous system, what are the major functions, and how it can be correlated with Ashtanga Yoga. So they come to know about the behavioral science as Yama and Niyama, the muscles, joints, their functions, and of course the importance of muscle relaxation in conscious efforts, that is Shavasana. They learn about sympathetic and parasympathetic system balance, which leads to energy conservation, and various types of pranayama. They learn what is the concept of pratyahar, that is what are sensory inputs and their effects, how to optimize them and minimize the effects which are troublesome to us. They do learn about concentration meditation, that is dharana, and they correlate it with the sutra Deshabandha Chittasya Dharana by practicing it every day. In addition, they are taught the concept of dhyana, the ultimate effect of dharana. In physiology, they are taught about the respiratory system, the effect of breathing on mind, effect of breathing on energy system, as well as the types of breathing. They are taught about the anatomical correlation of abdominal breathing as well as three types of thoracic breathing. In cardiovascular system, they are taught about the heart rate variability under the effect of autonomic nervous system and how does science of yoga has a role in its variation. For gastrointestinal system, they do know about how is the acid peptic disease troubling the patient, and patients is really tired of taking medicines again and again. So here is the basic concept of beyond medicines to help the patient so as to reach the cause of the trouble, of the complaint of the disorder, and to deal with it. So in a way, our medical yoga teachers, after completing the course, help the society who really don't want to take the medicines again and again and to reach the final destination of health. Thank you.